this video, we're going to discuss Freud's theory of gender development. Before we begin, trigger warning, that's on all of these gender videos, but especially in the case of Freudian theory, you might find some of the ideas here disagreeable. You'd be very surprised, naturally, if you didn't. But if you want to discuss some of the comments, that's fine. Just remember, keep it civil. Okay, let's do this. Psychboost.com, over 170 videos to help you with your qualification, and Patreon supporters can access bonus resources, tutorial videos, and the Discord channel. Psychodynamic explanation of gender development. So I imagine you do already have a general understanding of Freudian theory. I'm going to cover everything you need to know for the gender unit, but Freud has a few complex ideas, let's say, that I'll mention but not be able to fully explain. So if you're feeling rusty on Freud's ideas, I suggest checking out my psychodynamics video in the approaches unit first. So what do I mean by psychodynamics? It's the study of how the interaction between our unconscious and conscious mind influences what we do, what we feel, and how our personality is expressed. These ideas have been applied to gender development. Freud's psychoanalytic theory suggests that our sexuality and our gendered behaviour is a result of unconscious thought processes that are shaped during the five psychosexual stages. The third phallic stage, at around 5 years old, is particularly critical in developing sex-typical behaviour. At the phallic stage, boys are thought to resolve the Oedipus complex. They express sexual feelings towards the mother, but the father is there as a rival. Now, as the father is much bigger than the boy, he's scared of the father and experiences something called castration anxiety, a fear that the father will find out and remove the boy's genitals. Understanding that he can't win the mother's affection from the father and the father is too big physically to fight, the boy resolves the complex by deciding to be like the father, becoming his ally, and through a process of identification, learning his father's masculine behaviours. According to another psychoanalyst, Jung, a similar process happens with girls called the electrocomplex. The girl competes with the mother for the father's love. They resent the mother, thinking that she's responsible for the loss of her penis, a concept called penis envy. But eventually the girl realises she can't compete with the mother, identifies with her, and then develops feminine behaviour, and replaces her penis envy with the desire for a baby. So let's be clear on these concepts. If I asked about the concept of identification, what we mean is in order to be accepted by their same-sex parent and not be seen as a sexual rival, the children decide to act like the same-sex parent. That means they feel the need to imitate the same-sex parent. Now, according to Freud, this imitation results in a permanent change. The gender role is internalised, they've resolved their complex and they've exited the phallic stage with a sex-appropriate gender role, which is, of course, a mirror of their same-sex parents' behaviour and attitudes. Research evaluations. Well, Freud did attempt to back up his ideas. He released an in-depth case study of a five-year-old boy he called Little Hans. The boy's father sent a series of letters to Freud as he was growing up. And these letters included details of a phobia of horses and some dreams that Freud interpreted as evidence that Hans was experiencing the Oedipus complex. Hans was particularly scared of white horses with headgear that Freud said was similar to Hans's father's glasses and facial hair. One dream in particular, where Hans sat on a crumpled giraffe while another giraffe shouted out, was interpreted as Hans' desire for his mother, the crumpled giraffe he sat on, and the larger giraffe as his father. Now, because of the nature of psychodynamic theory, it's difficult to test empirically, and there is very little research that actually supports Freud's ideas. But when we look at some of Freud's predictions, they don't seem to play out. Because Freud's theory suggests that little boys need to identify with their father in order to develop masculine behaviours, you might be thinking, well, what about single mothers or lesbian families? Well, Stevenson and Black conducted a meta-analysis of 67 studies investigating father-absent families, and they found that, actually, there was very little difference in children over 6 years old with or without fathers. In fact, the small significant difference that they did find was the wrong way around. Boys without fathers actually had more stereotypically masculine behaviours. Green investigated the gender development of boys raised in lesbian households compared to heterosexual families, and they found no difference. Now, both of these results suggest that there doesn't need to be a father figure for boys to develop a masculine gender identity. And these findings may surprise you a little. And I think that's partly because Freud's ideas have in part shaped how people think about gender, and sadly used to criticise the abilities of both single gender and single parent families. Now, this research shows that this criticism is incorrect, and reminds us that we need to be aware of the consequences of psychological theories. We can also use the Martin and Little study from the previous cognitive video. That study clearly showed gender preference and behaviour in children as young as 3 years old, younger than Freud suggests children take on a gender identity after resolving the Oedipus complex. General evaluations. One problem Freudian theory is always going to have is concepts like the Oedipus complex are unconscious processes. There's just no way to directly scientifically measure or test these ideas. That means that they're not falsifiable. We can't show in an experiment that the Oedipus complex isn't real. So it's just not a scientific concept. A massive problem with the evidence that comes from much of psychodynamic work, including the little hand study, is it's based on case study research. This method is open to bias, both from the researcher, who can read too much into their observations, and the subjects, who may want to give the researcher evidence. Also, often just examples of one individual, so unlikely to be generalizable. I mean, the book that Freud writes about little hands is a great example. The father is well aware of Freud's theories, and the way that he questions hands for content for Freud, well, let's say it's a little weird, and almost designed to get answers Freud can interpret however he wants. Also, the world that Freud developed his theories in no longer exists. Back then, most people grew up in nuclear families with strict gender roles. And now there's a much wider variety of families. That means that Freud's theory likely lacks temporal validity. But let's finish on a positive evaluation. There is some face validity to Freud's ideas. Many parents of small children will report that the child will have a particularly close attachment with the opposite sex parent for a period in their development that they eventually grow out of. Here is a real exam question from 2019 on Freud's theory of the Oedipus complex. Give it a go and see how you do. I want to thank everyone who supported this channel over on Patreon during the development of this gender unit. You've helped made the development of these A-level videos possible. And if you're a PsychBoost patron, then you're on level and above, you can access bonus gender tutorial videos over on psychboost.com. And in them, I'll talk you through a model answer for the exam questions and talk you through some general exam tips based on the exam reports. But for everybody else, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the videos released right up to your exams. And I'll see you in the next PsychBoost video, social learning theory applied to gender development.